In this video, we're going to use linear approximations to express and estimate the given quantity. So the first quantity that we're going to estimate will be sine of 0.1. Okay, and before we do that, let's write out the formula for the linear approximation. Okay, so it's going to be L as a function of x subscript 1 is equal to the function of x subscript 0 plus the derivative at the point x subscript 0 multiplied by the difference of the x subscript 1 minus x subscript 0. Okay, so that's just, this is just the formula for the linear approximation. Okay, so, but in order to use this formula, we have to first find a function. And the function's obvious here, right? The function that you're going to use is going to be sine x. Okay? So the f of x is going to be sine x. That's going to be the function that we're going to use. So now, keep in mind that here, x subscript 1 is going to be 0.1. Okay, that's already whatever's inside the input. Now, x subscript 0 will be the closest point to x subscript 1, and it will be less than x subscript 1. Right? Because here we're going to subtract x subscript 0 from x subscript 1. So we have to find the x subscript 0, which is just below 0.1. So what do you think that's going to be? We know that 0 is below 0.1, and we know that sine of 0 is 0, right? We know that for sure. So we can actually use 0 as subscript, as x subscript 0 here, okay? So x subscript 0 is equal to 0, and that's less than 0.1, which is equal to x subscript 1. So we're good to go. So now, first of all, the function of x subscript 0, right, because that's what we need for the formula, right, that's going to be sine of x subscript 0, which is sine of 0, and that's going to be 0. Okay, now the derivative, first let's find the derivative of x. That's going to be, what's the derivative of sine x, right? This is the function, so the derivative of that is going to be cosine x, okay, as we all should know. So now let's actually get to the point x subscript 0 in there, right? So we can do the derivative at the point x subscript 0 is going to be the derivative at the point 0, right? Because we decided that x subscript 0 is 0, right? And that's going to be what? That's going to be cosine of 0, right? Cosine of 0. And we know that's equal to 1. Okay, now the difference between x subscript 1 and x subscript 0 is going to be precisely 0.1 minus 0, right? Because we have these two parts here. Okay, so that's going to be equal to 0.1. So that's unchanged. So now we can actually determine using the linear approximation the estimation of the quantity in question, which is sine of 0.1, right? So that's going to be the linear function as a function of x subscript 1, and x subscript 1 is 0.1. that's exactly what we want to find, right? Sine of 0.1. so that's going to be, now let's plug in the parts, 0, right, plus the derivative value, which is 1, times the difference between these two x values, right, which is 0.1. okay, and that's going to be 0.1. now if we use the calculator, and make sure that you're in the radian mode, if we use the calculator to find out what sine of 0.1 is, it's going to give us, let's see, it's going to give us 0.09, right, 0.09983 3417. Okay, now if you round it to the nearest whole number, the nearest tenth, it's going to be 0.1, right? So you have about the same value, but there's no, I mean, you can't get any closer than that if you use the point That is the input, which is the closest one to 0.1. Okay. If you tried pi over 6, for example, it would be 0.5. Right? And 0.5 is farther from 0 than 0.1, obviously, right? So you could not have used pi over 6. So that's pretty much it. Let's now try the second example. The second example is to find the value of sine of 1.0 using the linear approximation. So here we have to worry about the x subscript 0 because we have to find that. We know that the x subscript 1 is going to be 1.0, right? The given input. Now x subscript 0. Now we know that the x subscript 0 must be less than x subscript 1 in value, right? So it has to be directly below 1.0. Now what is directly below 1.0? The input whose sine that we know and that input directly below 1.0 is going to be pi over 6, right? Because if you use your calculator, pi over 6 gives you 0.52, right? So we're going to use pi over 6 as the x subscript 0. Okay, pi over 6. So now we can directly, I'm not going to do it in parts, I'm just going to plug everything in. So the linear approximation of 1.0 is going to be the function value of x subscript 0, so that's going to be sine of pi over 6, right? Sine of pi over 6 plus the derivative value of pi over 6, and the derivative is cosine, right? So cosine of pi over 6 multiplied by the difference of the two x values, right? So 1.0 minus pi over 6, 1.0 minus pi over 6, okay? So that will equal 1 half sine of pi over 6 plus radical 3 over 2, that's the cosine of pi over 6 value, 1 minus pi over 6, okay? 1 minus pi over 6. And of course, we're going to use the calculator for this. Let's see what it gives us. 1 half plus 3 radical divided by 2 times 1 minus pi over 6. Okay, so that's going to give us I'm going to try this one more time because I'm going to do 1 minus pi over 6 first, then I'm going to multiply this by radical 3 over 2, and then I'm going to add 1 half. Okay, I think pi over 4 is even closer. So I'm just going to erase this really quick. Pi over 4 is even closer to 1.0. Okay. So I'm just going to do pi over 4. So these will be different, of course. Okay, we know the function values will be different. So I'm just going to do pi over 4. Okay, use your calculator, pi over 4 will give you 0.78. Right, that's closer to 1 than 0.52. Right, so pi over 4 is closer. So pi over 4, cosine pi over 4, pi over 4. Radical 2 over 2, right, is the cosine, and sine of pi over 4 are equal at that angle, right? So that's it. So now let's use the calculator and find out what the value is going to be. So I'm going to do 1 minus pi over 4 times radical 2 divided by 2 plus radical 2 divided by 2. So I'm getting 0.85, 8853. 195. Okay, so let's use the calculator. If you use the calculator, okay, so I'm going to indicate this as the calculator result. Okay, and if you use the calculator, the sine of 1.0, and making sure that you're of course in the radian mode, right? 1 sine of 1 is equal to 0.84, something like that, right? So 0.84 147 0.0985. Okay, so that's the calculator answer. Of course, notice that there will always be an error because you can't predict it 100%. I mean, there's no 100% accuracy, but you will be close enough, right? Maybe by at most difference of 0.02, right? But it's pretty good. Okay, so let's try the last part. Let's try to figure out how to use linear approximation to find the value of sine of 9 over 4. Okay, so x subscript 1 is 9 over 4, and x subscript 0 must be, as usual, must be less than 9 over 4, and 9 over 4 is 2.25, right? So 2.25, just think about it. What is the angle that you're going to use that's barely less than 2.25? Let's think about it. We can't use pi over 2, right? That's not large enough. That's 1.57. What about 2 pi over 3? Let's try that. That gives me 2.09. Bingo, right? Because anything greater than that would be probably greater than 9 over 4. I mean, that's the angle that we know how to compute, right? So that's going to be 2 pi over 3. The calculator will give you 2.09, and that's exactly maybe 1/16 less than 9 over 4 value, okay? So that works. So let's go straight for that. Let's go the linear approximation as a function of 9 over 4 is equal to the function value of 9 over 4, so the function value sine of, I'm sorry, not 9 over 4, 2 pi over 3, right? Sine of 2 pi over 3, right? The x subscript 0, plus the derivative at that 2 pi over 3, so that's cosine 2 pi over 3, multiplied by the difference of the x values. The greater one is 9 over 4, of course, not minus 2 pi over 3, okay? So using the calculator, let's see what we get. So 9 over 4 minus 2 times pi divided by 3. Okay, making sure that you're in the radian mode, of course, because you're going to compute the angles, times the 2 times pi divided by 3, taking the cosine, plus input 2 times pi divided by 3, taking the sine. That gives me 0.78 222955. Okay, and let's see what the calculator does. If we plug in sine of 9 over 4, making sure we're in the radian mode, 9 over 4, taking the sine, gives me 0.778073197. You see, close enough. Close enough. Basically, the difference of 1/100, right? Precisely, right? Definitely well within the 2/100 error. Okay, so this is pretty good. As you can see, this linear approximation worked very well for all these three examples. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. Hope you subscribe as well, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.